Hello guys, welcome to my class. Today we are going to design a 5-story RCC building. Today we are gonna learn a lot more new things. Okay, so let's begin. Here is the plan of the building. This is the typical beam slab layout plan. I marked the different column property as a different color. You can see this is the property for these columns. Okay, and these are the beams property for these beams. Okay, so let's begin to the design. At first open Step Pro. Click on new project, click on space, give a name, building, choose location, length in meter and force unit, click on return, then click on next, select end beam, then finish. We are going to start creating nodes from this column. Okay, create a node. So each of the snap node cream grid. Now select node cursor and select the node, copy the node. For copy from keyboard Ctrl C and paste Ctrl V in the X direction. This is the X direction, and the node to node distance or column to column distance is 3496. You can see these are the distance center to center. All the distance are center to center, means the center of the column to the next center of the column. This is how we draw the columns, or you can say nodes. Okay, so this is the first column, and the next column should be in this distance, that is center to center. This is important. Okay, so the next column will be 3496 in the x direction, 3496, which is in the meter, 3.496. click on OK, then select the next node by node cursor, copy the node, Ctrl C, paste on Ctrl V in the X direction. Next node or beam distance is 3304, which is 3.304. OK, again select the node, copy the node, paste the node in the X direction. Next distance is 3.6 meter, and the next one will be 4150. 3.6, and next will be 4150. Okay, now select the whole nodes. I'm going to copy the nodes as a distance 4 meter. The all distance are same, center to center distance are same, and I'm going to draw 1, 2, 3, 4 nodes in the Z direction. Now select the nodes, go to transition repeat in the Z direction. Now steps 4, spacing 4 meter, and hit OK. Now our nodes are created. Okay, now we are going to draw these sides of nodes. Start from this node. This distance is 3.9 meter, then 3.8, then 4 meter. Select the node. Copy the node, paste the node in the x direction, minus x direction, 3.9, then 3.8, similarly minus direction, then minus 4. Okay. Next distance is 3.7 meter, which is 1, 2, 3, 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Select the node, go to transition and repeat in the x direction, num of steps 4, minus 4 meter, sorry, 3.7 meter. Then hit OK. So it will be in the x direction. For going back, Ctrl Z, press Ctrl Z from your keyboard. Now select the node, go to transition and repeat in the x direction, num of steps 4, minus 3.7 meter spacing. Okay. And the last distance is 3250. Minus 3.250. Okay. Now we are going to draw this side. This side distance is 4 meter, all the nodes. Okay, then 2.750. Now select the nodes, copy, paste in the Z direction, minus Z direction. Okay. Again, select the nodes. For select multiple nodes at a time, press Ctrl from your keyboard. Now Ctrl C, Ctrl V in the Z direction, minus 2.75. Okay. Press Ctrl Z, copy the node, paste the node in the Z direction, minus 2.750. Okay. Now we are going to draw these two columns, or you can say nodes, in distance of 4 meter, two nodes. Select the two nodes, copy the node, paste the node in the Z direction, to minus 4 meter. Okay. So our base is complete. Now select all the nodes. Copy the node, paste the node in the y direction, 1 meter foundation. Okay. Now go to front view, select the upper nodes, go to view, view select object only, go to isometric view, and you can see we have to draw these beams. Okay. These beams. The center to center distance is 2.1, 1.6, and 1.750. Middle, select the middle node, Ctrl C, Ctrl V in the Z direction, minus 2.1. Okay, this is copy paste in the Z saturation minus 1.6. Okay, the next will be copy paste in the saturation minus 1.750. Okay, now we have to link the nodes as beam. For that, select the cradle nodes, go to geometry, connect beam along x axis and z axis. You can see these two beams are not attached, or you can say not linked, so we have to do by manually. For that, go to add beam, linked the nodes, and for that, because this is not joined in by node to node, this is perpendicular. For that, go to geometry, go to add beam by perpendicular intersection, select the node and just go to the opposite beam, and you can see this is joined by perpendicular. Now our nodes are created. Go select this option for display whole structure. Now we have to join the nodes in y direction. For that, select the nodes, go to geometry, connect beam along y axis. Okay, now go to front view, select the upper portion by beam cursor. Okay, now go to transition and repeat in the y direction. Number of steps 4, spacing floor to floor distance 3.3 meter, and remember you have to select link steps. Where we selecting the link steps? Because we are going to copy the whole portion with linked. Hit OK. And you can see the portion are linked. See, now there are some linked portion are extra. Or then go to front view, so top view, select the three nodes by beam cursor. Press Ctrl from your keyboard for multiple selection. Go to view, select object only, and these are the extra beam. Select the beam and delete. Press delete from your keyboard. Yes. Go to whole structure. Why are we deleting the nodes, sorry, columns? Because these are the beam, not columns. Again, go to front view, select these two column, because there are no column. You can see this is not, there are no column. Go to view, select object only, go to front view, sorry, asymmetric view, and select the column. delete those columns, go to whole structure. Now we have to give them property. At first we have to give support. For that, go to support page. Click on create and fix support. Go to front view, select node cursor, then select the nodes. At first you have to select at first the supports. Select the nodes, then click on assign to selected teams, then assign yes. Now supports are created. I have to give the property. Go to property page, then define the rectangle. The properties are for column 250 into 550, then 250 into 500. Now 550 by 250 and 500 into 250. Next is 450 into 150, 450 into 250, and the next is 400 into 250, and for the beams 250 into 500, 500 into 250, and 250 into 450 is already created. 250 into 400 already created. 250 into 350. 350 into 250 and 300 into 250. And close. Now go to top view. For the column, go to plan. These are the red column, and you can see the big columns with property of 250 into 550. Now select the columns are carefully. Select beam cursor. Now select these columns. Press Ctrl from your keyboard. Go to front view. Let's count the columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. These two. click assign to selected beams and assign yes, and the big ones are created. Now switch to next column, 250 into 400, which are these sides. Okay, these two corner and this side. Select the property first, then select the beam cursor, select the column by pressing Ctrl from your keyboard, select assign to selected beams, assign yes. Now next columns are 250 to 450, which are these four, these three, this one and these ones. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Select the property first. Select beam cursor, press Ctrl from your keyboard. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These two. Now go to front view, count the column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. One is missing. This one. Now click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. You have to be careful when you are giving the property for the column and beams. Okay, now the rest columns will be 215 to 500. These are take your time, there is no hurry. Select assign to selected beams, assign yes. Now go to 3 view, to do see if any columns are misses. No, all columns has property. Okay, now I have to keep the property for beams. Now the first beam is 215 to 300, which is this one. Go to top view, 215 to 300, select this beam, assign to selected beams, assign, yes. Then 215 to 350, which are these two, these two. These two and these two. Then 215 to 400. B3 beam, these sides and these sides. Select 215 to 400, 215 to 400, 215 to 400. Now select the beams, press control from your keyboard. Assign to the beams, yes. Now next beam property is 250 into 450, the yellow ones, and this goes this total side. These sides excluding this one, 215 to 450. To press control from while pressing the keyboard, sorry, beams. Now assign to select beams, yes. And the rest one is 250 into 500. Select the beams. make sure you have selected all the beams. Then click on assign to selected beams, assign, yes. Go to 3D view, see any member miss the property. No, all the property are given. Okay. Now you have to keep load. For that, go to load page. Load case detail, click on add. Load type date. Title date and live and close date self weight and member load will be -16.5 and full load -5.6 and the wide range will be 1 meter to 14.2, 1 to 14.2, and close. Self weight goes to whole structure. For that, go to assign to view, assign, yes, and the member load. Go to select beam parallel to X. Select beam parallels to Z. Go to top view. Select these beams. Click on assign to selected beams, assign, yes. Now go to live load, click on add, click on full load, -2, minimum 1, maximum 14.2, add, close. Now go to command, loading, load combination, 1.5, add. So the first part is complete. Now we have to analyze it. For that, go to comments, analyze, perform analyze, no print, okay, analyze, run analyze, save. This will take some minute, 1 second. If there is no error, then your property, or you can say your model is okay. You can see there is no error, no warning. Now you can design int access design. Okay. In the next video, I'm going to design it. Okay, so thank you for watching my video. If you have any problem, comment on my video. Okay, thank you.